In this video, I will share with you how to take psychedelics safely. First off, do not be predisposed to psychosis or schizophrenia, because psychedelics could awaken these in you if you are predisposed to them. If you are not, then you should be fine in this regard. But also, if you are facing depression and you are on antidepressants, you want to get off of these at least 7 days before the trip. Preferably 14 days. Do not combine psychedelics with antidepressants, SSRIs especially, because the combination can cause you serotonin syndrome and many other problems. Make sure your substance is pure. If you are taking magic mushrooms, there is pretty much no chance they would be laced with anything. But with magic mushrooms, be aware that there are poisonous lookalikes. They are relatively easy to identify, but a beginner mycologist could make a mistake. But with synthetic psychedelics like LSD and MDMA, it is much worse. MDMA pills are notoriously cut with other drugs, such as meth. And you don't want to put meth in your mouth if you value your long-term health and brain health. LSD usually isn't cut, but there is a substance called 25-INBOme that can be dangerous. As little as 2 tabs of this substance can be lethal. And NBOme is also mostly sold on blotters. The only way to truly know that you do not have 25-INBOme or that you don't have meth in your MDMA pills is to test them. I will link to a test kit in the description. It costs you like $20 and it can save your life. If you are not willing to test your MDMA, you better avoid it altogether. And if you are not willing to test your LSD tabs, at least do not put them on your tongue. If you don't know if your LSD is pure, swallow it instead of putting it on your tongue. Because if it actually is LSD, it will get absorbed either way, whereas NBOme will not get absorbed if you swallow it. But of course, it is best to test the substance to make sure. Take the substance in a safe environment. This is a must. This can have a profound impact on the state you will be in during your trip, but also on your safety, of course. If you take LSD or mushrooms in a club or on a street, that is a horrible setting. First off, you will probably become extremely paranoid and anxious, you will probably get a bad trip, and you also will be more vulnerable if you take psychedelics. So be aware of that. Some people like to take these drugs in nature, which I would say is fine, but if you are taking higher doses or it is cold outside, please take these substances at home, because you never know what's gonna happen, and higher doses especially can cause you to reach a breakthrough where you will become unconscious. At least you will not be able to move your physical body. And the last thing you want is to be lying on the ground, tripping in the forest until midnight, especially when it's cold outside. Have a trip sitter nearby. Ask a friend you trust, preferably somebody who has taken psychedelics in the past, to take care of you. If you truly are an experienced psychonaut, you could trip alone. In fact, I do it myself, but be sure that you are not going to harm yourself. Because again, you never know what's gonna happen. So if you decide to trip alone, get rid of all the dangerous objects around you, like kitchen knives, scissors, handguns. Keep your body warm when you are tripping, because psychedelics can worsen your ability to thermoregulate and to generate enough heat. MDMA, on the other hand, has the opposite problem. It tends to make your body too hot, in which case you definitely want to stay in a cold environment, at least somewhat cold. Because if you are in a hot environment, that actually increases the neurotoxicity of MDMA as well. And there are people who have died because they spent the whole night dancing on MDMA and overheating. Which brings me to another point, stay hydrated. This tip can save your life if you are taking MDMA. With other psychedelics like LSD and psilocybin, there is no chance that you will dehydrate yourself to the point that it would cause any long-term problems. But the trip can also become unpleasant if you don't get enough water. So drink enough, but also don't drink too much. Some people hear the tip that they should drink a lot of water on MDMA and then they actually end up drinking too much water. So do not go over half a liter per hour, and preferably add a pinch of Himalayan salt to your water. Because the reason why people die from overhydration is not necessarily the water itself, but it's the depletion of electrolytes, salt specifically. Do not mix psychedelics with other drugs if you don't know what you are doing. Psychedelics and alcohol, a horrible combination. It will heavily decrease all the potential benefits and heavily increase all the potential negatives. This combination will likely not kill you, but it actually could if you end up vomiting and then you choke because of that. Alcohol in itself is, in my opinion, a dangerous substance, so be aware. Mixing psychedelics and weed is extremely physically safe. However, it might not be mentally safe, because weed will greatly intensify your trip. The trip will be multiple times more intense. The same can be said about mixing psychedelics with nitrous oxide. But nitrous tends to be so pleasant that it likely will not cause you a bad trip. But I would not take nitrous oxide in the first place, because it does have some long-term side effects, especially if you use it the wrong way. Mixing psychedelics with other psychedelics like LSD with mushrooms or mushrooms with MDMA, all of that is likely safe. It's just that the trip will be more intense. Another safety tip, a pretty important one, is to be in a decent state of mind before you take the psychedelic. If you are planning to trip and then you hear some bad news, like somebody from your family has died or you got fired from your job, do not trip that day. First, you want to process these extremely negative emotions associated with the things that are happening in your life, and then you want to trip. Because if you take acid or take mushrooms right after something horrible has happened to you, you can be sure that the psychedelic will evoke the emotions and make them even more intense. This in a way is good, because the psychedelic forces you to process the emotions and transcend them, but the emotions can be too overwhelming and hard to handle. Do not start with an overwhelming dose. If you don't have any experience with a certain substance, do not jump right into heroic doses, especially when there is nobody around, because you don't know how sensitive you are to the substance, you don't know how you will react to it. However, and this is extremely controversial, but I do not think that starting with tiny doses is the best either. Because if you start at tiny doses, your ego will be able to take control of a psychedelic state. And once you move into higher doses then, your ego will still try to take control, but you will get to the point where it cannot. And if you just slowly progress into that point, your ego will not expect that to happen and it will try to hold on. And when this happens, this is the main reason why people who take psychedelics responsibly still get bad trips. It is because they are unwilling to let go. So while I wouldn't start with an overwhelming dose that is too intense, I also wouldn't start with a tiny dose. So in my opinion, taking an equivalent of 100 micrograms of LSD or 1.7 grams of dried magic mushrooms is the best. And from there, you can slowly build your way up. Also, it might not be the best idea to start with some heavy, intense psychedelics. DMT isn't that big of a problem if you don't have previous experience with psychedelics. But if you don't, and you take salvia at first, or 5-MeO-DMT, that's not a good idea. That can be too overwhelming for somebody who has not taken psychedelics. I do not have experience with salvia, so I should keep my mouth shut when it comes to that one. But from what I've read, I would not take salvia before taking LSD or magic mushrooms. That could actually cause you some long-term psychological problems. Letting go and surrendering fully to the experience is such an important tip, by the way. Not only for enjoying the trip and benefiting from it, but also for reducing the potential harm. If you don't let go and you try to hold on to your sense of self, and you try to run away from the emotions that the psychedelic is trying to show you, that can cause a terrifying experience. Not only will you not enjoy it, but you could actually end up harming yourself because of that. And people have in the past committed suicide because of these bad trips. It's no joke. Open up your physical body and be prepared to die. You will not die physically, but it might feel like dying in your mind. When you agree with the death and you accept it, or when you just accept the negative emotions that are coming at you, the trip will most likely be extremely euphoric. But if you instead try to hold on to your sense of self and you try to push all the bad emotions away, it can turn into hell. And then be careful with certain substances. You certainly don't want to take Datura if you value your physical health and your mental health at least a little bit. And be careful with the substances that have a relatively high potential for harm. 5-MeO is an example of that. I am a huge fan of 5-MeO-DMT, but if you don't take it the right way, you could die. If you ever decide to take 5-MeO-DMT, do not eat at least 2 to 3 hours before the experience, because the substance can make you vomit, and then you may end up choking because of the vomit. It is unlikely to happen, but it has happened in the past. I love you. Thank you so much for being a responsible psychonaut, and share this video if you know anybody who is also into psychedelics.